Got a car here for you.
We have a breaking story out of Point Verdun where witnesses have reported sustained gunfire. This network, as well as New Bordeaux police, have been unable to substantiate these reports, but we'll update you as soon as we have more information.
Stop at the corner shop and get some milk. Hello there!
You want the best milk shop? This is the place. You want the best milk shop?
Thy lone one to pine on the stem. Since the lonely are sleeping, go sleep thou with him.
You already finished with Barbieri.
Barbieri?
No. By a long shot. Already told you. That he's slow. As for you. Show up like Lazarus himself. Name thinking of myself. This jockey bastard is either one of the luckiest sons of bitches that's ever lived, or the kind of man that invites rotten damn luck. So goddamn sure it was the latter. I have to admit, I was wrong about you.
You can thank me by calling me by my name.
Aye. Lincoln it is, then. It was funny. Things get taken from us. We convince ourselves we'd go out and inflict pain on someone else. A little mend what's busted up inside of us. But it doesn't, does
it? No. It does.
Spent my entire goddamn life scratching and clawing at anyone who came along. Even if they were there to help. Look where it fucking got me. It's the sense. Change it. Only way is forward.
Now that Irish Point is back under your control, I'm gonna need you to bring in as much money as you can. Going after Marcano ain't gonna be cheap.
I imagine you'll be wanting your cut of the proceeds.
That's right.
Can't say I'm a fan of someone looming over me. But a deal's a deal. I asked Nikki to manage those moonshine runs, but she can't bring them all on her own. That liquor hauls in a fair amount. We'll talk to her. is around here somewhere if she ain't out quail hunting.
Quail ain't in season.
Oh, for her kind, it's always in season. Yeah. Oh. You'll excuse me. I was going to see Mr. Barbieri. He's probably getting a little lonely. Lonely.
Shit. If a Dunn gets any more, Mickey, they're gonna have to paint it green.
I need to get out of the city soon, I think.
I used to love going to Bobby Yai's deli, but it hasn't been the same quality.
Is that a Hot Wheels just like you ordered?
Folks like this ain't fun for me, usually, and it don't have to happen. Just pay me what's fucking due, understand?
Listen to me!
Little Red Riding Hood.
You think I forgot what you did? You can blame Marcana all you want, but it was your men who ambushed us.
My men were following orders. We got rules. Not my fucking problem that you people don't understand.
Yeah, well, I'm about to make it your fucking problem.
This shit is this, then.
Goddamn. If it ain't the city's favorite pot-licking donkey, Thomas Burke.
The fuck did you just say to me?
Put the gun down, Burke. It's gonna take all four of us to bring down Marcana, so I don't want any more of this stupid bullshit.
Bring down Marcana? These two used to work for Marcana. And this one? Do you know how many of my men this canard killed because Marcana told him to? Fuck him, and fuck you if you think I'm ever gonna trust
these
two. Hey,
get the fuck out, Dan. There's no sweat off my ass.
You don't trust him? Good. Because I don't trust any of you. But that doesn't change the fact that I destroyed Barbieri's operations, killed Doucette and those other redneck motherfuckers, and saved your ass from Greco's men. So here's what you need to decide right fucking here now. Either fall in line or get the fuck out. Just know, second you step out that door, your name's getting added to my list right beneath Marcano's. Now, if we're all done acting like goddamn children, let's go over the plan. In order to bring down an organization the size of Marcano's, we need to eliminate the people at the base and work our way up. It's the same thing I did in Oz.
I know the military filled your noggin with all manner of tactics and schemes, but let's not overthink this shit.
Say we go out to his house and shoot him. Shouldn't take more than an hour or so, depending on traffic.
And what you think gonna happen after? Everybody else just gonna lay down and die, you stupid-ass motherfucker?
Cassandra's right! Just killing Marcano doesn't get us anywhere. One of his brothers will take over, and we're right back where we started. So, first, we go after his lieutenants. Then, once they're killed, we seize their territory and move on to the capos. Once the lieutenants and the capos are killed, Marcano will be isolated and alone. And that's when we go after him.
Hold on, what happens to those territories we get from Marcano's guys?
Once it's in our hands, I'll decide who gets to run the day-to-day. I give you a district, you get the rackets and everything else. But I'm also counting on you to hold it. Keep that bastard from reclaiming it. One last thing. Y'all know that building that's going up across the lake? Hmm? He's building a casino. Marcano's constructing this so he can go legit. All his money's tied up into that thing, so once he figures out what we're up to, it'll limit his options. More importantly, it's an emotional attachment. Emotions make people irrational, greedy. So that's where we hit him. Right in the goddamn heart.
Hey, nice speech. Think they bought it?
Don't care. They're all too greedy or pissed off of Marcano to back out now.
At least until one of them decides to try the crown on for size.
Well, if it comes to that, I'll handle it. The photos were a nice start and all, but I'm gonna need some actionable intel on those lieutenants. A place of business, where I can find them, you name it.
The dossiers are nearly complete. I'll be ready to move when you are. I was also able to recruit some concerned citizens who are more than happy to share what they know about Sal's coalition of WAP assholes. Information on how to contact them will be included with the other intel.
Appreciate it.
Sure you don't need a ride?
Oh, I do my own driving.
Ooh. And the systematic killing of Marcano's capos and lieutenants, that was part of the plan.
Well, you're playing fucking patty cake, Christ. Look, you want to bring somebody down, you destroy the foundation they're standing on. It's the same basic op we ran over Nam.
This is New Bordeaux News with an update in the Hollis Dupree trial. Defense attorneys for the elderly South Downs resident claim he was simply reacting to the recent wave of colored-on-white violence that has plagued New Bordeaux. The defense also painted a damaging portrait of one of the victims, Trey McCall. He apparently spent time as a teenager in juvenile hall for undisclosed crimes. Dupree's defense is being paid for following an outpouring of public support for the Korean War veteran.
You ever heard of Enzo Conti?
Think Sammy mentioned him a time or two?
He's 61, old school mob. Been running Barclay Mills for decades. He started off extorting the railroad and moved on into industrial waste. All the heavy construction equipment and supplies for the casino, steel, concrete molds, that kind of thing, was all brought in via Enzo's trains.
All that shit has to be worth millions. Enzo didn't just hand it over to any cat who walked in the door. Marcano's a felon, so he's gotta have a partner, someone who's legit.
If he does, that person's buried deep. I went through the paperwork. It's a goddamn maze.
Which means we need to get Enzo to tell us who it is.
According to my sources, Enzo's not a big fan of the casino. Thinks anyone who's not Sal Marcano's gonna end up getting fucked.
So I might be able to use that to flip him?
Probably have to squeeze him pretty hard, but it's worth a shot. He's still involved in the railroad and has to store all that industrial waste somewhere, so I'd start there.
Once I take his district from him, I'll give him a call from the motel, offer him an out.
And if that fails, you could always give him a Hanoi hangman.
Look who it is. Good to see you up and breathing, Connie.
Fuck, man. He got kind of crazy when you was taking over the warehouse in River Road, but I got out all right.
Heard you know something about the Barclay train yard.
Yep. This is more independent-like between the two of us. That friend of yours in the nice tan suit figured you need eyes and ears on Pete Santini's shipping operation.
What's Santini up to?
He's a protection man here in Barclay. You want to see whatever you put on a train end up where it's supposed to be? You gotta pay Pete's people.
Sounds kind of small time for one of Marcano's outfits.
Give the man a prize. Ever wonder why this city's got so many guns? Marcano and Enzo got Santini running them. You bust up them deals and you put the hurt on Pete's business.
All right. I'll see about getting my hands on that map. Be seeing you.
Drill, lean on Santini's people, see what they got to say.
Yard bullets, the kind you can topple over and put your mind to it. How can the Johnson administration not see this? I've been hearing folks worry that, we don't want another Vietnam. What I and what the Reds hear when we send a strongly worded message about their invasion of another country is that we just don't want to fight.
Now, dear listen, I want you to see the kind of country we're sliding into.
What kind of values we're showing the rest of the world? Imagine opening up a paper in London or in Paris and seeing that your friends in the United States wouldn't be sending armed forces to aid the Czechs, but in the last decade alone, the same country hasn't been shy about sicking the National Guard against its own people over in Little Rock. None of us have forgotten that, have we? Now, this isn't a dig at the boys serving in the Guard, no. But you see my point. Instead of preserving liberty abroad, the Johnson administration would make us a nation that suppresses liberty at home. Even New Bordeaux can't escape the overreach of the Johnson government. The Attorney General has essentially told the state of Louisiana that it must pursue charges against Hollis Dupree, a man accused of the crime of defending his own home. President Johnson and his people seem more concerned about satisfying interest groups than they are making the world safe from the spread of communism.
How's it hanging, pal?
I got my fucking earplugs. Fucking train's right around. I'm gonna wreck my ears.
Hell, I'm just mine. You can get back later.
They been in your ears.
Yeah, my ears, not my ass. Christ, princess.
How'd he get in here?
You're gone.
To ignore no black.
Well, well, don't mess your panties
shit,
over.
Shit, I can't tell where that nothing. Fucking noise come from.
Oh, shit.
Shit! He's picking us off!
He's been doing some small-time gun sales. I know where he's been stashing the money.
Seen you in an age.